Hi, I'm Tharegha Manoharan, and I'm a sophomore at Shrewsbury High School. Today, I will be presenting a poem that answers to the question, should Andrew Jackson be on Mount Rushmore? The great Mount Rushmore is open to take more. The seventh president, Andrew Jackson, now needs an action. Shall he be added, or is it considered invalid? Shall he stay? 'Cause how can he be on display? All of them are white rich men, again and again. Can't there be anyone else? Many in our great nation have acquired progress, and their paths are a unique way to attain success. Such as Martin Luther King Jr. to Susan B. Anthony and Maya Angelou, and many more thought to be losers who took the impossible and pursued. But back to our question, is Jackson a worthy suggestion? Does the man who not only owned slaves, but also traded them and sent them to their graves, deserve a monument among our nation's braves? Although some may admire his victory and affectionately call him Old Hickory, those who lost their culture, dignity, family, and entire life forever call him the sharp knife. The only reason they agreed was because they thought they would get something in return for them to succeed. There was a voluntary Indian migration, but only a small number were in cooperation, as they were expected to move to a new location. In 1823, the Supreme Court decided on a report claiming the Indians could occupy the U.S. lands of gems. However, they could not be entitled to them. The Cherokees decided that in order to save what was left of their land, they needed to be undivided and not follow the government's demand. They tried to resist in hope their non-violent strategies could help them coexist. Large-scale farming, slaveholding, and Western education were all things they tried to help a new generation. But this just made their white friends jealous and resentful and wanted their ends. In 1830, President Jackson took an action that caused dissatisfaction. He pushed a new piece of legislation, which was a regulation allowing him to negotiate removal treaties. The Indians saw him as greedy. He compelled the Indians to give up their lands to their unwanted guests and move west. Although this was all supposed to be voluntary and peaceful, because of their love of their land, the Indian people resisted, and Jackson persistently insisted. As the people's culture was in subsidence, believing they were children in need of guidance, Jackson took on a role that was both patronizing and paternalistic, making them believe this change was optimistic. Removal could save them from the depredations of the whites. They could go to a new area and not suffer from malaria. They could govern peacefully and live on successfully. For the next 28 years, the United States government interferes and leaves the southeastern nations in tears. Many of the tribes refused. The Seminoles believed their treaty was bruised. This led to war after war, and at the door, the U.S. had to pay the remaining to ignore and move on towards the West Shore. The Creeks were forced out because of the problems about. The Chickasaws were tricked with the treaty in conflict. All in all, the U.S. recalls, they kicked out 46,000 native people from their land to the 25 million acres in the West, which opened up white settlements, slavery, and more stress. With all these major problems caused by the United States government's wobbly columns, none other than Andrew Jackson, who definitely does not deserve attraction and more, fails to be part of the majestic Mount Rushmore. Thank you.